What's up there, crew? Matt here with TRW, and this is Ask Matt, Season 2, Episode 209. So today's question comes from Miss Pine. Miss Pine's question was, Matt, when just starting out, other than the actual product, what else are you putting in the box for the customer when you send it to them? Are you putting washing care instructions? Are you putting extra business cards? What other types of things did you used to put in the boxes when you did the finished product side? All right, Miss Pine, so a few things I love to do. If I were just selling someone a basic decal, maybe it was on eBay back in the day and it was only an $8 decal, I would make them a second one for free because it took me another 11 cents in cost, right? And maybe another minute to weed it. But I give them that second decal and now they love it. Hey, you are a random winner for a bonus decal. And I would write them a hand little note, okay? Just to make them feel good, to show that I provide a good customer service and I was providing awesome items. Another thing I used to do, if they got a full color decal when I did the Roland Versacam decals, the print cut, right? I would throw another little decal in there just as a little sample because the kid would probably love it. Put on the back of their cell phone, put it on their computer laptop, in their bedroom, whatever they want, right? Or put it on there and put a little note on the back for batting helmet decals. And now what that does is it gets that mom or that dad to bring the decal to the coach and say, hey, check out these awesome batting helmets. And the decals we can put on our batting helmets from this company down in Florida that does this. Another thing I love to do, my business card had all of my social media stuff on it. And I would say, hey, go sign up for our Instagram account. And you will get a coupon code. Go sign up for Facebook and like us on Facebook and you will get a coupon code. And I used to do a pretty cool little trick, okay? So here's what I would do. People would say, well, you do that for Facebook, but how do you know that they sign up? So on the business card, it would say something like, go like our Facebook page and comment, thanks for the awesome order and post a picture. Okay, and then they posted a picture of their order. Obviously, I knew they ordered from me then. Then I sent them a special coupon code for 20% off their next order. So think about that. They're doing something for me. I want to do something for them, giving them a 20% discount. So now they buy a $10 decal, they get it $8, right? They buy a $30 shirt. Now they're getting $6 off that. So now they're getting that shirt for $24. They're saving some money. But more importantly, it's building my Facebook page or my Instagram account or whatever it is. And not only that, it's giving awesome feedback because they're saying how much they love the decal. Now, when other people go to my Facebook page and they see all those awesome responses and all those samples of people showing off their decals, that's well worth the $6 savings on the shirt that they're going to buy next, right? And it's bringing them back for customers again. And I would literally email every single one of them or respond to every single one of them and say, thanks, Sandy. Appreciate you sending that. You get 20% off your next order for posting your shirt or your decal. I just emailed you with your coupon code. And then other people see that. And again, it just takes off and it snowballs from there. So just thinking of, I always try to think of cool things. And believe me, I did a lot of different things that didn't work. But one of my favorite things was getting more advertising and putting it into, I even got to the point at one time where when I had sales reps out there, basically, I had all the moms that, and I said, hey, if you sell 10 shirts, your next shirt's free, right? Which ended up being cool. So I had little forms, I'm talking 8 years ago, that I used to put a little piece of paper that I would print out and it would explain to them our kind of referral program. And have your customers or have your friends enter this coupon code when they buy a shirt or buy a decal on our website. And when you sell 10 items, then you get a free, you sell 10 decals, you get a free decal. You sell 10 shirts, you get a free shirt and so on. And what that did is it allowed me to have sales reps all over the country. So just thinking of different things, take advantage of that. Don't just send them a shirt, okay? Don't just send them a shirt and an invoice. Send them something to kind of make it more personable, to let them know that you're a great company and you're a great business and make them want to come back and order from you again. So that's my advice on that. Hopefully it helps some of you guys out. But try new things. It doesn't mean all these things will work. Believe me. Like I said, I did a ton of things that didn't work. But because I did a ton of things, some of them did work. And when they did work, then I went all in on those. All right. So click that like button, subscribe, little bell right next to it, but then the real subscribe right there. Comment below. Give me some more questions for the Ask Matt here. Appreciate all of you guys, and I will see you guys soon. Leaving for California for the Santa Clara show tomorrow. All right, crew. Later.